डियर स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू खाना किंगडम स्मार्ट एजुकेशन ऑनलाइन क्लासेस और चैप्टर नंबर 3 प्लेइंग विथ नंबर्स। इन दिस चैप्टर वी विल रीड डिविजिबिलिटी रूल ऑफ 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, देन 8, 9, 10, 11। वी हैव रीड डिविजिबिलिटी रूल ऑफ 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 8, 9, 10, 11। नाउ सम मोर डिविजिबिलिटी रूल। द फर्स्ट रूल इज इफ ए नंबर इज डिविजिबल बाय अनोदर नंबर देन इट इज डिविजिबल बाय ईच ऑफ द फैक्टर्स ऑफ दैट नंबर। Now, for this divisibility rule, I test a example. 36 is divisible by 18. A number is divisible by another number. 36 is divisible by 18. Then each of the factor of this number also divide the given number. Now factors of 18, which number can divide 18? 1 can divide, 2 can divide, 3 can divide, 4, 5, now 6 can divide, 7, 8, 9 can divide, and 18 can divide this number. These are the factors. Now 1 can divide 36, yes. 2 can divide 36, yes. 3 can divide 36, yes. 6 can divide 36, yes. 9 can divide 36, yes. So all factors of 18 will divide 36. All of the factors will divide the given number. Now, rule number 2. If a number is divisible by 2 co-prime number, what is co-prime number? First of all, what is co-prime number? What is co-prime number? If there are not any common factor of given numbers, then the numbers are called co-prime number. These are not the prime number, but the common factor is not present in these numbers, so they are called co-prime number. Now rule number 2, if a number is divisible by 2 co-prime numbers, then it is divisible by their product also. The product of 2 number can also divide the given number. For example, 18 can divide by 4 and 5. Factor of 4 is 2 into 2, factor of 5 is 1 into 5. There are not any common factor, so they are co-prime numbers. 4 and 5 are co-prime numbers. Now, प्रोडक्ट ऑफ देम 4 इंटू 5 इज 20. नाउ प्रोडक्ट ए कैन डिवाइड द गिवन नंबर 20 कैन Let take beginning from this. If a number is divisible by two co-prime number, then it is divisible by their product also. Example, 80 is divisible by 4 and 5. The factor of 4 is 2 into 2. Factor of 5 is 1 into 5. There are no any common factor. So 4 and 5 are co-prime numbers. Now their product. 4 into 5 is 20. 20 can also divide 80. So this rule is correct. You can take a screenshot of this. We will move to our next rule. Now our next rule is rule number 3. If two given numbers are divisible by a number, then their sum is also divisible by that number. For this theorem, we take example 16 and 20, both are divisible by 4. 16 can divide by 4. 20 can divide by 4. Now 16 plus 20. 16 plus 20 is 36. 36 can divide by 4? Yes, 36 is also divisible by 4. 16 can divide by 4, 20 can divide by 4. So 16 plus 20 is 36. 36 is also divided by 4. Next rule is, if two given numbers is divisible by a number, then their difference means subtraction, is also divisible by that number. I am taking this example again. 20 and 16 both are divisible by 4. Now 20 is divisible by 4, 16 is divisible by 4. Difference of them, 4 can divide 4? Yes, 4, the difference is divisible by 4. You can take a screenshot of this. We will move to our next topic. Now our next topic is prime factorization. First of all, what is the factors? Let a number, I am taking 36. First of all, factors of 36, which means which number can divide 36? 1 can divide 36, 2 can divide, 3 can divide, 4 can divide, 5 cannot. Now 6, 7, 8, then 9, after 9, 12, then 18 and 36. These numbers can divide 36. These are the factors. But These numbers are not prime number. 2, 3. 2 and 3 are prime number. Remaining are not prime number. So we taking prime factorization. In prime factorization, we will factor in multiplication form. Here is factor in comma format. Now we will multiply factors to get the numbers. How to make? We make a tree diagram. By a tree diagram, we can find the factor of 36. This is our 36. We can break into two numbers, 2 into 18. 2 is 2, but 18 can divide into 2 and 9. 2 is a prime number, but 9 is not prime number. We can divide 3 and 3. 3 into 3 9. 9 into 2 18. 18 into 2 36. These are the prime numbers, so called prime factorization. 36 can written as 2 into 2 into 3 into 3. 3 into 3 9. 9 into 2 18. 18 into 2 36. These are the prime factorization. We can also write this number as 4 into 9. 4 is not prime number, so we can break this number 2 into 2. 9 is not prime number, we can break this number 3 into 3. 36 factors are 4 into 9. 4 can break in 2 into 2. 9 will be break in 3 into 3. Now 36 is equal to 2 into 2 into 3 into 3. We can also break this number as 3 into 12. 3 is a prime number, leave this, but 12 is not prime number. 2 into 6, 6 is not prime number. 2 into 3. Now 3 2 2 and 3. So 36 is 2 into 2 into 3 into 3. These are the prime factorization. You can also start this from 6 into 6. 36, 6 into 6. 6 will be break in 2 into 3, 6 will be break in 2 into 3. So 36 is equal to 2, 2, 3, 3. 2 into 2, 3 into 3. These are the prime factorization. You can take a screenshot of this. We will move to our exercise. Now, in exercise 3.5, question number first, which of the following statement are true? A. If a number is divisible by 3, it must be divisible by 9. Answer. The statement is false. The statement is false, not true. Because, let an example, 12 is divisible by 3, but 12 is not divisible by 9. The statement says it must be divisible by 9, but 12 is not divisible by 9. 12 is not divisible by 9. Now next one is, if a number is divisible by 9, it must be divisible by 3. The statement is true. (Clears throat) बिकॉज 3 इज ए फैक्टर ऑफ 9, 3 इज ए फैक्टर ऑफ 9, सो इफ ए नंबर इज डिविजिबल बाई अनोदर नंबर देन फैक्टर्स ऑफ अनोदर नंबर विल ऑल्सो डिवाइड द गिवन नंबर द फैक्टर ऑफ 9 इज 3 सो 3 कैन डिवाइड एनी नंबर विच इज डिविजिबल बाई 9 यू कैन टेक ए स्क्रीन शॉट ऑफ दिस वी विल मूव टू आवर नेक्स्ट पार्ट नाउ आवर नेक्स्ट पार्ट इज सी ए नंबर इज डिविजिबल बाई 18 इफ इट इज डिविजिबल बाई both 3 and 6 if a number divisible by both 3 and 6 then the number is also divisible by 18 no this is wrong because 3 and 6 are not co-prime numbers 3 into 6 is 18 product the product rule these numbers will be a co-prime numbers but 3 and 6 are not co-prime numbers Answer here is 3 and 6 are not co-prime numbers so if a number is divisible by 3 and 6 both the number must not be divisible by 18 statement is false the statement is false for example 24 is divisible by 3 8 times and 6 4 times 3 and 6 both but 24 is not divisible by 18 18 cannot divide 24 now next one if a number is divisible by 9 and 10 both then it must be divisible by 19 this statement is true The statement is true. Here 9 and 10 are co-prime numbers. There are not no any common factor between them, so they called co-prime number. If a number is divisible by 2 co-prime number, then product of them can also divide the given number. You can take a screenshot of this. We will move to our next part. Now our next part is part E. If two numbers are co-primes, at least one of them must be prime. It is not compulsory. So the statement is false. The statement is false. For example, 9 and 10. The factor of 9 is 3 and 3. Factor of 10 is 2 and 5. These are the composite number, but not having any common factor. They are not having any common factor, so these are the co-prime numbers. 9 and 10 are co-primes, but both are composite numbers. Now next one is, all numbers which are divisible by 4 must also be divisible by 8. If a number is divisible by 4, then the number is also divisible by 8. False. Why? Taking example, 12 is divisible by 4, but 12 is not divisible by 8. The all number which can divide by 4 must be also divisible by 8. False. 12 cannot divisible by 8. Now next one, all the numbers which is divisible by 8 must also divisible by 4. 4 is the factor of 8. So the factor of 8 is also can divide the given number. So this is true. Answer: 4 is a factor of 8, so all numbers which are divisible by 8 must be divisible by 4 by our factor rule. You can take a screenshot of this. We will move to our next part. Now our next part is part H. If a number exactly divides two numbers separately, it must be exactly divide their sum. This statement is true. The statement is true by rule number 3. The rule number 3 is, if a number exactly divides two numbers separately, it must be exactly divide their sum. For example, 16 and 20 is divisible by 4. Then 16 plus 20 is 36 is also divisible by 4. The two numbers divide separately, it must exactly divide their sum. Their sum is 36. 36 is also divisible by 4. Now next is, if a number exactly divide the sum, it must be exactly divide two numbers separately, the reciprocal of this. But this is false. Taking an example, 3 plus 5 is equal to 8. 8 is divisible by 2. 8 is divisible by 2. A number exactly divide the sum of two number. Sum of two number is divisible by 2. It must exactly divide the two numbers separately. 3 can divide 2, divisible by 2. 5 can divisible by 2. But 3 and 5 is not divisible by 2. You can take a screenshot of this. Our next question will be taken in our next video. Thank you for watching this video.